Just before he charges up another blast again to finish you guys off, the escape rope is called and you all teleport back to the ship.
I like to think that I still have my momentum and just slam into the deck.
You all land downwards and...
Luckily, I only took 25 damage.
Instantly gets a first aid kit and gets to work.
Vendi dusts himself off. You guys all right?
Sit back down, you're not done yet.
Oh, yeah, sorry. He sits down.
The two refugees come over and hug Venti, like, immediately, and says, thank you so much, that was amazing.
Hey, these hugs are for everyone. Everyone did a great job. Group hug, everybody. Come on. I see you two over there. He points to Scarlet and Layla, come on.
She comes over reluctantly and just puts a hand in the circle.
Hold on. You hear, like, the evolution music. It's turning white. It's looking more like a butterfree. Stop that. It's even, like...
Metapod looks up to you.
I don't know why.
Metapod looks up to you like, please, just kill me.
So what's Scarlet doing?
Scarlet's just gonna stand over here like, yeah, I'm not part of that group, so...
It does, but you're our friend, though, right?
Yeah, Scarlet's still a bit shifty, like, yeah, but, yeah.
I mean, I'm not asking you to join Team Vision, I'm just asking you to join a group hug. Layla joined the group hug!
That's kind of why I'm having that.
Whoa, Esme first, then Scarlet.
Oh, never mind, my sass will stay hidden.
Scarlet?
I was just saying, yeah, it's kind of because Layla's in the hug that she doesn't want to be in it.
Layla.
Well, this is easy. Let's change where the hug starts.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, that's a really good idea. Come on, guys.
They all come.
It's just like, oh, God.
Yeah. See? Good teamwork. Come on, Layla.
Layla used to have her standing next to Moonbug. Like, yeah.
All right. Layla just leans against the console, just knowing, you know, like she would just kind of ruin the moment for her. But as you guys separate, Layla approaches and says, so this is why we need your help, Scarlet. Like, these people need your help. And she, like, just carefully chooses her words, like, we need your help. I need your help. Can you just do one last thing? And then I promise you can go. And she holds up a USB drive. Just one last simulation.
I don't know. What is this... I'm doing exactly what's gonna happen once I've done all this.
She walks over and guides and says, it's just what you need and what, you know, this is good for you too. She guides Cosmoan over and says, we're gonna evolve Cosmoan so that we can help save the future.
Scarlet's very, like, she's proper, like, conflicted. Like, she wants to help people, but she doesn't want to help Layla after all she's done, so it's just a bit like lost and kind of just silent thinking things over.
That's a nice idea, but what's the fine print on?
She says, that's it. In this simulation, we're going to go to the altar of the sun, and there we're going to evolve Cosmoan into a Solgaleo, and we just simply want to borrow its power for a second. This one will allow us to seal off the nightmare timeline once we rescue everyone so that it cannot hurt anyone again.
So conflicted.
You versus the many.
Scarlet kind of just turns and looks at, you know, all the new friends that she's made and kind of looks back at Layla and is like, look, I don't like you, and I think you know that I don't like you and why I don't like you, but I can't do nothing when so many people are in trouble. I'll help you as long as you promise that you won't hurt any more of my friends and my family.
I swear, I won't do a thing. In fact, we can go home, we can get this sorted out, and she holds up the ho-ho feather for you.
Scarlet takes it and just puts it in her pocket.
She says, let's go, and let's go save the future, she says, kind of smiling. Is that okay with everyone?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right,
I'm just a guest character. My input doesn't matter.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just Vendy Steamroller.
Right, your input matters.
You guys head back to the laboratory, head into the simulator, insert the last USB, and head towards the Altar of the Sun. You can feel the mystical aura of this place, despite it being a simulation. Layla guides Cosmoan up to the center altar here, and she instructs Scarlet to head towards one of the dioses.
Okay, which one was the sun one? The sun's one's the right-hand side, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. On the other end, a figure suddenly appears.
What? Why is she here?
She is a simulation. You sense no life from her, minus a little bit of spiritual energy. Tired and hurt, you both begin to play your flutes. As you begin to play, Cosmoan starts to light up, and its light begins to flood the area. It touches you, and Scarlet, the symbol on the back of your hand, burns brightly as the light temporarily flies out, and it hits Cosmoan with the brightness of the sun. Cosmoan disappears for just a moment. A portal opens up, and Solgaleo jumps out to greet the party.
Kitty, my kitty.
You are fully bonded with it, and it has max loyalty.
Wow, nice. Hey, Venti, you'll like this guy. He's psychic steel.
Oh, right on. That's a good cat. But he's your cat.
He is best cat. I can pet him.
Goodbye.
He approaches the lot of you and starts snuggling. Just friendly. Friendly.
I like to think that it makes a couple of, like, cat noises. And Venti, while rubbing his nose, like, gonna miss you, Cosmog. And he, like, leans in. One for the road. Bless you, Cosmog. Bless you.
And with that, Layla comes over and just a beaming smile. And she says, thank you, Scarlet. This will be a big help to us. I promise. And I can't wait to save the future with you guys.
No. Scarlet, like, pats the Solgaleo on the nose and is just like, yeah.
The lot of you begin to leave the simulator and you head back into the laboratory.
Venti.
Yeah.
Tell me how to stop these tears.
Why would you ever stop something like that? You're just expressing yourself. Let it out, friend. Let it out.
Scarlet hands him a tissue.
Yeah, like the both of them both individually, like, cover each cheek with little hankies.
With that, you guys leave, and Layla says to the group, it says, hey, why don't you guys head back to the rec room, and I just want to talk to Scarlet for just a second.
Of course. Hey, Scarlet, nice job, kid, and see you around.
Thanks. It was nice to meet you guys. Really, thank you.
Of course. All right, guys.
Esme's gonna give her a bottle of headache medicine. Aww. And then just smile and walk away.
Oh, awesome. That'll be very helpful for guaranteed later events. Thank you very much.
Right. Oh, guys, let's roll out.
Love it.
I'm going to be a hero.
From Puce's lost story arc.
I'm looking for...
Wait, Scarlet just quickly runs after Esme and is like, Esme, I have something for you too.
Oh, what?
She takes like a red bow out of her pocket. And aww, just kind of like, aww, pops it on her hair and is like, there.
Oh, I love it. Thank you.
Gives her a big beaming smile.
Venti wipes away a tear with his chain. That's a true sign of friendship. See you around, kid.
You guys all head back to the rec room for a beer.
Hey. So, I need to talk to you for a second.
Yeah, sure. I guess.
First off, I want to say sorry for what I've done. I want you to know that everything I've ever done is for the sake of the future. The last few years of my life have been violent and unpredictable. The only stable thing I've ever known is Venti and my time here at Team Vision. I just wanted to save everyone and give them what they have given me.
Well, what you have done is pretty awful. And I can never say it's okay. You and your organization have killed several people, including one of my best friends. But thinking back to the Sea Banshee and Berg, I guess it's kind of hard to see better options when you're up against so much violence.
Yeah, but there's more to it than that. Back in my timeline, I lost everything the last time I saw this hand. It had a moon on it.
What?
I was born in the year 2020 to a successful gym leader and his newest girlfriend. My mother let my dumb father name me after his favorite Pokemon. She always let him have his way. We weren't a perfect family, but happy enough. My mother always said I got my father's good looks. He always loved that I got my mother's hair. And they both loved that we all had the same eyes. Mom loved fashion and helping Dad out with his brand. And thanks to what I learned from her, I could properly design a uniform and unite everyone under one name. This I all learned from you.
No. That can't be right. I can't be here.
Wait, don't leave. I'm so sorry.
But if you're my, then that means that Jesus and I...
Yeah. Like, low bunny, actually.
Oh my god.
Sorry, but can we...
You... me, I can't just...
I'm just so sorry.
You... I don't even know!
I'm so, so sorry. Especially for this.
Great work, Layla.
No!
Shut it, girl. This is for our vision. This is for our future. Necrozma! Consume!